Hello, welcome to aonlinetraining.com. This is Animate CC. Now for tools, I have go to the selection tool. That's I told you that selection tool, you have to be select any of the things. Suppose I select the stage. If I click it, you get the properties over here. Then I go to the basic shape. This is the line. Just click the line and drag on this stage. If you hold down the shift, it will be a straight in, horizontal, diagonally, or the vertically. I can select the tool and drag to select the line key. Then I see in properties of a palette bar, I can change the stroke color. So this is the stroke color. You can change the stroke color. And this is a fill color, which is not activate right now because we need a complete shape on the base of the stroke or a path. Now next, this is a stroke width. I can change the stroke width or stroke size. Then I can change my styles. This is how you can the stroke. Now I tell you how to copy this line or stroke. Just hold the Alt key and drag. You can change this line color like this. Even from selection tool, if I just hover my cursor, selection cursor on the line, then you see the curves shine. I'll drag it, it's bent. You can bend, you can make curve with the lines. Right? You can join these two lines by select this corner and just fix it over there. The same thing, another one. This thing. In shape, it's become the one. When you select the whole thing, it's just over the shape. Now next, go to the rectangle tool. Now rectangle tool is same as work as a shape. So in shape, you can select the separate the fill, shape and the stroke. You can select the stroke, double click and delete it. Same in rectangle fill area. If I go to another rectangle primitive tool, when I drag it and select the selection tool and just click it. As I did the rectangle tool shape, it's not like the same thing. This you have select this corner point and you can get the circle or the corner round of the rectangle. Same thing, you can change the width or the style of the line. You can change this profiles. This is only to happen in primitive tools, not in shapes. Then I delete this one. If I select this shape and I add more shape, this oval, if I just drag or drag like this. If you want the circle, so you have to be press shift and then alt, it's come the proportional circle. After that, if I select this shape and I just keep over this shape another shape like this and then click outside, you select, it's become a one shape. So guys, you have to be safe while you have overlapping the shapes. Again, I'll show you. If I just keep overlap this and I select the whole, it's become one. It is only to happen when you're working in similar layer, right? So if you want to be separate this one, I have to be just select, or you can redraw this shape also. So I have just select, added and cut and make the another layer, and I just add it and shape in the center. Center means in the center of the stage, and pasted in place where you have copied the piece. If I just overlap and when I select it, it's easy to select with this, but it's not out one piece of the shape because it's in separate layer. So I can just lock this layer, I can select this layer. This is, you can work on that. Second oval primitive tool, then I click this. Same thing, tools are given over here, you can work with that. Then oval options, start the angle. This is and the angle, so you can just half of the oval. This is the inner radius. This you can design your. This is a closed path that's made only to show the line. If you are just closed, it's become a complete shape. So as I told that in complete shape on the base of the path or stroke, you can easily change the fill area. Right, now next is my poly start. If I drag this poly start and select this, double click and drag it, same option is coming over there. Now this is a cap is square and this is a bevel. So if you see this corner point or corner joint will change from this. Then I go my pencil tool. If I just simply, it's a freehand drawing tool, can draw anything like this. You can change the width, like slope of it like this. You can just see line will come in different shapes. If you want starting or the end points like this, you just click this. So the end point is smaller than the start. Then I'll go my brush, paint brush. Paint brush is just paint on the shapes, same as on the base of the width of the stroke. This is how it is work. I'll just make the shape. I change the fill color. I change the stroke color. Just double click and select the all strokes, or I can just delete. Now I've selected this shape and I go to my paint brush and I select this paint color or I can just select tool, click outside, go to the paintbrush, then I will define my stroke colors and just paint this. There is an option, if this on, then you have to paint on drawing objects. If it's a paintbrush mode, is a paint smooth, if it's straight, then you can straight. It's all them straight. If it is ink, it's work like normal pencils also. This is a paintbrush. Then this is a brush tool. Brush tool always similar with the paintbrush, but there is something difference. For this I have go my oval, or you take any of the shape. Then I go my brush tool. Then I can change my brush size. This is the brush tip, and this is a mode of the paint. So if I paint as a normal, I change this color, it's a normal paint. If I change paint fill, it's only fill that paint with the fill in. Paint behind, if I just change my color and I just draw over there, it's only fill or paint my back of the fill area. Then I paint selection. If I paint as there, there's nothing to paint. So I have to be select this shape pixels. Then I go my brush tool and my mode is paint selection. So if I paint over there, it's only to paint on the selection shape. This is only to happen when you are working in shapes, not in primitive. Then paint inside, if I paint, so it's paint inside of the fill area. This is how you can paint your shapes. And just delete. Then I told this is I have paint bucket, so it's how it's work. So I have just design little bit shape and just double click delete, change this color, and I just take another shape. Now I select this shape, I go to my paint bucket. Either you can select the color from here, or you go in fill stroke palette. It's the same one. And these are the gradients of two colors. So I just select my gradient, any of them, under this. When you select this paint bucket with the gradients, automatically tools come. That means you can work on the gradient. If it's high, you can easily to go here. So about the solid colors, this is a gradient color, more than one color shapes, and the solid colors, you can select any of the color, it will change the color. If I can select the bucket, I can go over there, and the same color I've select, I just can play over there. Even in, not in stroke, because for stroke, there is an ink motor. So it is only to work in ink motor, that means on the stroke. So if I change, find my stroke, it's going to happen. If I want to be gradient inside of the stroke as with ink bottle, just double click, select this, and skip this. This comes. If you want to reset this, so I have go my this tool, select the third number under the free transform. There's a gradient transform tool. Just drag or you just select this. You can just move. You can just scale from constantly. You can rotate. You can change line. Anything you can do that. Okay. This is you can do that. Eyedropper. Eyedropper means this is a color selection tool. If I select this color, automatically I have get the bucket tool and I just click. It's automatically how it's based because I've select the stroke color, so it is only to fill on stroke. It's not fill on the fill area of the shapes. So remember which was the last tool we selected. If I just select this tool, then my input is there. If I select this, and then just fill on with any of them. So eyedropper basically the eye color selection. So it's based on which color selection you are doing, either it's stroke or a fill area. Then this is an eraser. So again, I have just click on my shape. Now what is the brush tool? Brush tool is again is work in shape tool, as I told you. Now from this is a mode, this is a faucet, that means on one click you can remove that any of the color. Then this is a tip how your brush is work. Now this is my erase normal. So if I just, it's a normal erase. For better understanding, I'll just double click my strokes and just click all my strokes. So erase, it's a normal erase. You can erase my shapes. Or after that, if you want to use this shape, this you can use separate. Then erase this tool and go to the mode erase fill. So let's fill this tool. And erase line, so you need to be as stroke. So I'm just taking portal and just fill over it. Eraser, this is my erase line. So if I just erase, it's only to erase my lines, not fill. Then erase selected fill, it's not fill because I'm not selected any of the fill. So it is only to work on the selected. Then there's an erase inside. If inside, that means it's cover from the around the lines and it's fill that erase that's fill. Okay. This is what is inside eraser. Now faucet, if I click off any of the color on similar shapes, colors, if it's one shape and split it because it's different shape because I did a erase it. So it is like that. It's a one shot to delete. You need to be to select then delete. Faucet is just click and it's automatically delete that. Okay. Now I take my line, just drag, and this is a width tool. Now what is a width tool? Width tool, when you hover this stroke, it's automatically change the width shape. This is how you can do it. You can just change the shapes from anywhere. This is what the advanced feature of the width tool. When you select the stroke, this is the advanced feature of this tool. Okay, and this is a hand for pan. You can pan when you are zoom out or when you zoom in, so you can pan your stage on this workspace area. And this is a rotation, you can rotate your stage as according to your walk in. When you walk in 3D, okay, this is for later part. Now, zoom tool, you can zoom from any corners and or for zoom out. Otherwise, you can work from here. Okay. Or you can press Control plus for zoom in and Control minus for zoom out. Right, guys? And this shortcut is coming over here. Second thing is this. This is the swap colors. If your stroke color is this and fill color is this, you can swap it. Okay. If the same selection, you can swap the colors. And this is a black and white, this is a default color. For queries, please contact us on info@aonlinetraining.com. Have a nice day.